Okay, good morning everybody. Welcome to this fluid mechanics class. Now, hope all of you have done well in the test. You got your scores, isn't it? So you got your test marks, and I think all of you have done quite well. I'm also happy with the way you have done, and I think you got a good insight into the first module, isn't it? There is no issue with the first module. All of you have understood the first module and the second module also. Okay, so all of you have seen your scores, so we'll continue further where we had left off. I'll just remind you, refresh what are the things we were telling last class before the test. So I think we were doing the module on dimension analysis, module 4. So in dimension analysis module 4, we solved certain problems on the Buckingham Pi theorem, and we solved quite a number of problems, and we calculated how to find the pi 1, pi 2, pi 3 terms, and finally end up with the equation for a particular variable that is called the dimension analysis. So we did that, and now the other part of the fourth module, the other part of the fourth module is boundary layer theory. Boundary layer theory. Okay. So please see the study material what I sent to you now in the fourth semester WhatsApp group. Please see the fourth semester WhatsApp group. I have sent the study material on boundary layer theory. Okay, please open the fourth semester WhatsApp group study material on boundary layer theory. Okay, yeah, so I'll just start the class now. So what do you mean by boundary layer theory? See, whenever a fluid flows along a path, that is say in a pipe, friction is bound to be there. Not only that, the water molecules or the fluid molecules go and stick to the sides or the wall of the pipe. When that happens, there is a layer formed at the walls of the pipes, and that is called the boundary layer. In the boundary layer, a thickness, a small micro thickness layer is formed at the boundary of the pipe. That is called the boundary layer. And we are going to study about the speciality of that boundary layer, and it's called the boundary layer theory. Okay, so just go through the study material what I have given to you on the boundary layer theory. See, it is nothing but a thin layer in the nearby region of the solid boundary where the variation of velocity takes place from zero to maximum, and it becomes a free stream velocity in the direction normal to the boundary. Now, a shear stress and a friction acts at that point, and it obeys the Newton's law, which states that shear stress is equal to mu into du by dy. The remaining portion of the fluid is outside the boundary layer, and therefore there won't be any variation in the velocity. So what I mean to say is, if there is a boundary layer, there is bound to be some friction, there is bound to be some velocity, and at the walls of the pipe, you can say. So boundary layer along a thin plate, I have sent you the study material, please open that. In the second page, you can see the boundary layer of a thin plate. So you take a plate and then let the initial velocity be u. Then what happens on the flat plate, from the leading edge, for a certain period of time, you have a laminar boundary layer. Then there is a transition region. Then there is a transition region. And then what happens after the transition? It becomes turbulent. All of you are aware of that. Initially, the water flows in a laminar way. Then there is a transition. Then it goes into the turbulent flow at the trailing edge. Now, the laminar boundary layer, the thickness of the laminar boundary layer, they are going to try to find out. That is called delta. Delta is called thickness of the boundary layer. Please see the study material what I sent in the fourth semester group. Please open that. Delta is the thickness of the boundary layer, and Rex is called the Reynolds number. It is equal to Ux by V. Okay, at a distance of x, which is equal to Ux by V. Capital U is called the free stream velocity of the flowing fluid, and nu is called the kinematic viscosity of the fluid. Okay, If laminar boundary layer, there is a laminar boundary layer, then the Newton's law of viscosity is applicable, because at the pipe walls there is a shear force, a layer is formed which is called the boundary layer. Now shear force is equal to mu into du by dy, it is applicable, and the velocity distribution is parabolic in nature. Beyond some distance from the leading edge, the laminar boundary layer becomes unstable, and therefore the flow is transitional. Okay. Later on, it becomes turbulent, as I told you. Okay. Now, for the turbulent layer, delta is given by 0.377x divided by Reynolds number to the power of 1 by 5. This is just a formula, and they are trying to find out what is the value of the Reynolds number for turbulent flow. And they have found that the critical Reynolds number is 5 into 10 power 5. That is the maximum Reynolds number that you can have, beyond which you can't have a Reynolds number. So I will just once again brush up, what is a boundary layer? Whenever a fluid flows in a pipe, it sticks to the wall and makes a layer in the pipe or whatever it is, duct or whatever it is. Therefore, that is called, the layer is called as a boundary layer. The fluid goes and sits there and makes a layer. Friction is caused, and that layer becomes adjacent to the wall, and the velocity increases from zero to maximum. That is called as a stream velocity. Now, what are the factors affecting the growth of the boundary layer? Okay, what is happening at the boundary layer? See, the distance from the leading edge. Supposing you have a pipe. Okay, what is the distance from the entrance of the pipe? Third one, density of the fluid. All of you know, density of the fluid plays a very important part. Viscosity of the fluid, mu. And free stream velocity, capital U. Free stream velocity, capital U. Okay, so this is something about what is boundary layer. What are the factors affecting the boundary layer? So what are the factors affecting the boundary layer? Distance from leading edge, density, viscosity, and free stream velocity, capital U. Okay. So after knowing so much, we have to see certain things. They are going to define certain things. What are they? It is called boundary layer thickness. That means how thick is the boundary at the wall? How thick it is? That is called the boundary layer thickness. That is called delta. Boundary layer thickness is called delta. It is proportional to 1 over capital U. It is proportional to 1 over capital U. What is capital U? Free stream velocity. Okay. So delta is proportional to boundary layer thickness is called delta. And this is a different kind of delta. This is not the rho or the other kind of delta what you are thinking. It's not density also. Delta means boundary layer thickness. It is proportional to 1 over free stream velocity. Okay. Given the material, please see that one, boundary layer thickness delta. So how do we define boundary layer thickness delta? It is the distance from the boundary of a solid body measured in the y direction to the point where the velocity of fluid is approximately equal to 0.99 times the free stream velocity. I'll repeat again. It is the distance between the boundary, distance from the boundary of a solid body measured in the y direction to the point where the velocity of fluid is approximately equal to 0.99 times the free stream velocity. Next to that, you see a sketch. You see a sketch where he is showing u and he is showing the graph 0.99 u. That height is called a delta. That height is called delta. So delta is also called the nominal thickness of the boundary layer, and capital U is equal to 0.99 times U. That is what he is telling. Then we have one more. We have one more. That is the displacement thickness. Displacement thickness delta star. Displacement thickness delta star. See, it is a distance perpendicular to the boundary of a solid body by which the boundary should be displaced to compensate for the reduction in flow rate on account of boundary layer formation. And it is denoted by delta star. See, you need not worry too much into all these mathematical aspects. All these things need not worry. just what is the definition of boundary layer thickness delta? What is the definition of displacement thickness delta star? These things you have to understand. So delta star is equal to integral of 0 to delta 1 minus small u by capital U into dy, that is called displacement thickness delta star, right? Now the next one is the momentum thickness. Okay, so we have spoken about first one is boundary layer thickness delta, then displacement thickness delta star, then momentum thickness is called theta. Okay, momentum thickness is theta, and it is defined as the distance measured perpendicular to the boundary of the solid body by which the boundary should be displaced to compensate for the reduction in momentum of the flowing fluid on account of boundary layer formation. It is denoted by theta is equal to 0 to delta small u by capital U into 1 minus small u by capital U into dy. Okay, that is called the momentum thickness theta. So you don't have to worry much about the sketches and all the things. Just remember the mathematical equation. What is momentum thickness theta? Theta is equal to integral of 0 to delta small u by capital U into 1 minus small u by capital U into dy. That much you should know. Then there is energy thickness. It is a distance measured perpendicular to the boundary of the solid body by which the boundary should be displaced to compensate for reduction in kinetic energy of the flowing fluid on account of boundary layer formation. It is denoted by delta double star. Delta double star. So delta double star is equal to integral of 0 to delta u by capital U into 1 minus small u square by capital U square into dy. Okay. So what are the four thickness that you have? What are the four things that you have now? Thickness. First is boundary layer thickness, delta. Delta is proportional to 1 over u. That is called boundary layer thickness. Displacement thickness, delta star. It is equal to integral of 0 to delta, 1 minus small u by capital U. Then momentum thickness, theta, is equal to integral of 0 to delta, small u by capital U into 1 minus small u by capital U into dy. Then energy thickness, delta double star, is given by integral 0 to delta small u by capital U into 1 minus u square by capital U square into dy. So these are the four thickness that you have in the boundary layer theory. So whenever a fluid flows in a pipe or if it's flowing in a duct, then what happens usually, a liquid, if you take water for example, if it's flowing in a pipe, then at the boundary, that means at the walls of the pipe, a small layer is formed, and this causes the friction. So when we are going to study about that small layer, that's called as the boundary layer, these four things will come into effect, and we have to see what is the value of these four things. What are they? Boundary layer thickness delta, displacement thickness delta star, momentum thickness theta, and energy thickness delta double star. Okay. So these are the four things, and this is a standard question in your video exam also. They are going to ask you about these four things. So you have to define what is the boundary layer thickness, energy thickness, momentum thickness, and the other one is the displacement thickness. So you have to define all these things and then write the mathematical equation for that. Okay. So this is very important. Usually VT is asking this repeatedly, okay, this question. So please go through this. I've shared the study material to you. Please open the first semester WhatsApp group. I just sent the study material. See, go through that. Okay. So four definitions you should know first. Boundary layer thickness, displacement thickness, momentum thickness, energy thickness. These are the first four things you should know. Definition, mathematical relation for each of them. Okay. Any doubts? Vinay? Hello? Can you hear me? Hello? Can you hear me? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And did you understand these four things? What I'm talking about a boundary layer?
Yes.
We're just trying to form. See, what we are trying to formulate an equation for each of the various things that are occurring when a fluid goes and sticks to a wall. Some boundary is formed. So what are the four things? They are boundary layer thickness, displacement thickness, momentum, and energy thickness. Okay, so we have to define all these four things. Okay, so once we define these four things, now there are numerical problems where they are going to give you an equation. So it is a velocity. So velocity is a vector. So they will give an equation for the velocity. You have to find the boundary layer thickness, momentum thickness, energy thickness, displacement thickness, all these things you have to find. Okay. So just see the problem. First one, I just given you. First problem. The velocity distribution in the boundary layer is small u by capital U. It is equal to 3 by 2 into y by delta minus half of y by delta square. Just go to that problem. Got it? Prayag, just open that page, man.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the problem. So what is telling? The velocity distribution is given. Okay, that's a boundary layer. There is some velocity distribution. Velocity is a vector quantity, so it will be in the form of a mathematical equation only. So it will have both have both magnitude as well as direction, isn't it? So he has given you this equation and is asking you to calculate the following. What are the ratio of delta star by delta? And second one, ratio of theta by delta. Okay. So how do we solve this problem? First one, he is asking ratio of delta star by delta. So you should know what is delta and what is delta star. So what is delta? Delta is the boundary layer thickness. Delta is the boundary layer thickness. Pranay, switch off the video. Yeah. Delta is the boundary layer thickness. And what is delta star? Displacement thickness. Okay. So let us find both. Now delta, you know, delta star will be equal to, what is the formula? What is the mathematical formula for displacement thickness? Delta star is equal to integral of 0 to delta 1 minus small u by capital U into dy. Okay, this problem is very simple. Okay, it appears to be mathematically complex, that's all. So that is equal to integral of 0 to delta 1 minus, yes. What is the value of u by u? It is the equation what he has given, that equation u by u. Substitute for the value of u by u, that 3 by 2 y by delta is there, no? You substitute that one here and then close the bracket into dy. Okay, so delta star will be equal to, now you have to integrate this whole equation, open the bracket. So you will get y minus 3 by 2 delta into y square by 2 plus 1 over 2 delta square into y cube by 3, integrating it from 0 to delta. Okay. So integrate this equation and substitute for 0 to delta. So delta star will be equal to delta minus, when you integrate this, you will get y square by 2. So 3 delta square by 4 delta plus delta cube by 6 delta square. So it's equal to delta. You simplify this equation, you will get 5 by 12 delta. Okay. So delta star by delta is equal to 5 by 12. Because delta star is equal to 5 by 12 delta divided by delta. So the answer is equal to 5 by 12. Now all that you have to remember in these kind of problems is, what is the mathematical equation for delta? What is the mathematical equation for delta star? For theta and for the energy thickness. These three things you should know. Once you know these four things, just substitute that value directly. What he has given in the equation, whatever equation he gives you, you substitute that value integrate it, you will get the value of the concerned variable. Okay. Okay, so then first one is over. Second one is asking you the ratio of theta by delta. Now, how do you define theta? See the material what I have given you. Theta is what? Momentum thickness. So momentum thickness theta is equal to 0 to delta u by u into 1 minus small u by capital U into dy. So substitute for u by u, whatever is given here, substitute that value and you will get 0 to delta integral to 3 by 2 y by delta minus half. You put the value of y by delta here, you get y square by delta square minus half 3 by 2 y by delta, this whole square, u whole square. Simplify, okay, 0 to delta, put all the y delta terms on one side and simplify here. Open the bracket and simplify. And you will get the equation as theta is equal to this equation. So you keep simplifying from the value of 0 to delta. Now, the final equation you will get, theta is equal to 3 by 4 delta minus delta by 6 minus 9 by 12 delta plus 3 by 8 into delta minus delta by 20. So simplify this, you will get 19 by 120 delta. Now what he has asked? Find the value of theta by delta. So theta is equal to 19 by 120 delta divided by delta. So it's equal to 19 by 120. That's all. Okay, so whatever he has asked, we have calculated. The only thing you should know is what is the mathematical equation for boundary layer thickness delta, for momentum thickness delta double star and theta, sorry, then for energy thickness delta double star and displacement thickness delta star. Okay, any doubts, Alap? Did you understand this problem, Alap?
Yes, sir.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
You should know the definition of boundary layer thickness, definition of momentum thickness mathematically, and energy and boundary thickness.
Yes,
just sir. Substitute that value, and you would have given an equation there. Okay, velocity equation. Put that velocity equation into the formula and simplify, integrate. That's all. If you integrate, you will get the final value. I'll just do one more problem, then you will understand better. See, the second problem, what we are given here, the velocity distribution in the boundary layer, go to the second problem. The velocity distribution in the boundary layer on a fixed plate. So there is some fixed plate there, some fluid is flowing. It has formed a boundary, a film on the surface of the plate. And the velocity distribution is given mathematically as small u by capital U is equal to y by delta. Okay, where small u is the velocity and delta is the boundary layer thickness. So it's asking you to find two things. Find displacement thickness. Displacement thickness. Second one, energy thickness. Energy thickness. Now what is displacement thickness? How it is defined as delta star. Okay, and the energy thickness is defined as delta double star. Okay. So equation is given, small u by capital U is equal to y by delta. Now, let us calculate the displacement thickness. How to calculate the displacement thickness? First step, write the mathematical formula for displacement thickness. That is delta star is equal to integral of 0 to delta 1 minus u by capital U. That is the mathematical equation, standard equation for delta star into dy. So delta star is equal to substitute for u by u. Substitute for the value of u by u. U by u is what? Y by delta. He has given us y by delta. So substitute y by delta into dy is equal to y minus 1 over delta into y square by 2. You are integrating between the limits 0 to delta. So you simplify. Delta star is equal to, if you simplify, delta minus 1 over delta into delta square by 2. Okay, put the value of delta and you will get final value. Delta star is equal to delta by 2. So what is delta star? Displacement thickness. So you have found the value of displacement thickness, delta star. Now to find the value of delta double star, that is called energy thickness, isn't it? So energy thickness, delta double star. So what is the standard mathematical formula for delta double star? Integral of 0 to delta, small u by capital U into 1 minus u square by u square into dy. Substitute for u by u. What is u by u? Y by delta. So put y by delta into 1 minus y by delta whole square into dy. Okay. So open the bracket. Simplify. From the limit 0 to delta, you integrate. If you integrate, you will get delta double star is equal to delta by 4. Okay. The answer delta double star, which is nothing but energy thickness, is equal to delta by 4. Okay. Any doubts in this? Any doubts? Ritik? Ritik? Did you understand, man? Ritik? Are you there or not? Jitin? Jitin?
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
yes,
did
sir.
You understand?
Yes, sir.
You understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, whatever study material I have given, okay, whatever study material I have given, you see that you go through that. So in that, I have given the definition of the four things: boundary layer thickness, momentum thickness, displacement thickness, and energy thickness. So you will have to write the definition and the mathematical equation for each one of them. Okay. Then coming to the problems, we have solved two problems, isn't it? So problems will be similar in nature. If you know the mathematical formula for each of these thickness, then you just have to substitute whatever equation he has given, simplify the equation and integrate the equation from 0 to delta, you will get the final answer. Okay, that's what I said. It's very simple, though it appears to be very complex. Okay, this is all that you have to do. Okay, any doubts in this, sir? This is called the boundary layer theory. It comes in module 4, the second part of module 4. Okay. In last class, we have finished the dimensional analysis, isn't it? So we have solved many problems. And the other half of the fourth module is this boundary layer thickness. It's called the boundary layer theory. Okay. Any doubts in this, you tell me. Okay. We have got some more problems to do in the boundary layer theory and flow past immersed body. So once you do that, okay. So once we finish the boundary layer theory, we'll be completing around nearly 60-70% of the fourth module. Okay. Any doubts in this? See, please solve more problems in this. Many of the students, I think, have shared almost all the modules to you, either in Google Classroom or through the first semester group, isn't it? And if you have RK Bansal, it's the best thing to do. Just go through those problems, whatever are there, okay? In the boundary layer theory also. Just go through that, okay? Then you can understand very clearly what are the different kinds of thickness and how to calculate the different kinds of boundary layers. Okay. Any doubts in this? Hello? Yeah.
Can you
repeat? Tell me. Yes. What do you want me to repeat? Tell me. Problem, huh? You came now?
Yes, sir. I forgot the name of the plan.
Okay, no problem. So, Jayant. Jayant, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay, no problem. I'll just repeat once again. So what do you mean by a boundary layer theory? Say whenever the fluid is flowing in a pipe, you see that some of the molecules go and stick to the sides or the walls of the pipe, and it forms a layer. That layer is called the boundary layer here, boundary layer. And a theory is based on that, and the Prandtl's theory is based on the Prandtl's theory. And because of that, a friction is caused, and on the layer we find a small film occurring on the boundary or the walls of the pipe. This is called the boundary layer theory. So what they are trying to do is they are trying to find out if whether the flow is laminar or flow is turbulent, what is happening actually. So to do that, they have used this boundary layer theory, which states that the Reynolds number initially is a laminar flow, then it comes to transient flow, then it becomes a turbulent flow. So they are going to study how the flow is getting changed from laminar to turbulent. And during that process, the velocity becomes very important, which is called the free stream velocity, denoted by capital U. And there are factors which are affecting the growth of the boundary layer. What are the factors that are responsible? Are distance from the leading edge, that is from the entrance, then density of the fluid, viscosity of the fluid, and the free stream velocity. All these four things are there. Okay, so they are going to define based on this four thickness theory. They are called as a boundary layer theory. First one is called boundary layer thickness delta. Okay, boundary layer thickness defined by delta. So how do you define delta? It is the distance from boundary of solid body measured in the y direction to the point where the velocity of fluid is approximately equal to 0.99 times the free stream velocity. The free stream velocity is defined as capital U. Okay. Then the boundary layer thickness is denoted by delta. And the mathematical equation is delta is proportional to 1 over capital U. Now two things are there. Small u is the velocity. Capital U is called the free stream velocity. Okay. So the boundary layer thickness delta is defined. Then displacement thickness delta star. Delta star. So delta star again is defined as a distance perpendicular to the boundary of the solid body by which the boundary should be displaced to compensate for the reduction in flow rate on account of boundary layer formation. See, you need not get too into the depth of this. That is not required. You should know what is the definition, first one. Second thing, what is the mathematical equation? That is very important. Okay. So delta star, which is nothing but displacement thickness, is given by 0 to delta 1 minus small u by capital U. Okay. Then the other one is momentum thickness defined by theta. Okay. And theta is equal to integral of 0 to delta small u by capital U into 1 minus small u by capital U into dy. Okay. Then energy thickness delta double star is equal to 0 to delta small u by capital U into 1 minus small u square by capital U square into dy. Okay, these are the four things which I am going to ask you. You have to define and write the mathematical equation. So what are they? Boundary layer thickness delta, then displacement thickness delta star, energy thickness delta double star, and momentum thickness theta. Okay, these are the four things that you have to find out. Yes, Jayanta. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Understood, no? So yes, there are problems on that. Yeah, there are problems in that. Sorry. I'll just explain one problem again. Okay. I'll take the first problem only. Those who are coming late, just note down this. I'm doing the first problem. Okay. Now the velocity distribution in the boundary layer is given by T just see the material what I given you, Jayant, in the fourth semester group I put it, see that material. Small u by capital U is equal to 3 by 2 into y by delta minus half into y by delta whole square. This is the velocity equation what they have given. And they're asking you to find out ratio of delta star by delta and ratio of theta by delta. Okay. So the first one, ratio of delta star by delta. How to do that? So delta star you find out. Okay. Delta star is equal to, yes, what is the mathematical equation for a standard equation for delta? Delta is proportional to 1 over u. And what is delta star? 0 to delta integral 1 minus small u by capital U into dy. Now, you take that 0 to delta integral into 1 minus, what is small u by capital U? That equation value, 3 by 2 into y by delta. Substitute that value of u by u here, close the bracket, into dy. Then expand inside, expand, and integrate from 0 to delta. So you will get delta star is equal to delta minus 3 by 4 delta plus delta by 6. So simplify it further, you will get delta star is equal to 5 by 12 into delta. So delta star value I found out, it is equal to 5 by 12 into delta. And what is this first one is asking? Ratio of delta star by delta. It is 5 by 12 delta divided by delta, which is equal to 5 by 12. First one we completed. Second one is asking you ratio of delta by theta. Yeah, sorry, theta by delta, sorry. So theta by delta, you have to find theta. What is theta? Momentum thickness. So what is the standard formula for momentum thickness? 0 to delta u by u into 1 minus small u by capital U into dy. Substitute for the value of small u by capital U in the, substitute this given equation. What is the value? Substitute from 0 to delta, you put that value into dy. Now expand this equation into dy. Then what you do, you have to integrate this value, integrate from 0 to delta. Once you do that, you will get the value of the integral. Then theta is equal to, you will get equation, simplify that equation, simplify the equation, and finally you will get theta is equal to 19 delta by 120. 19 delta by 120. So what is actually theta divided by delta? So theta is equal to 19 delta by 120 divided by delta. It will be 19 by 120. Okay. So all that you have to know is what is the mathematical equation for momentum thickness, displacement thickness, and energy thickness. Okay. If you know that, substitute that. And whatever equation is giving in the velocity vector form, you substitute that equation, simplify, and integrate it from 0 to delta, you will get the final value. Okay? Any doubts? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Got it. So when you solve more problems, next class you can do more problems. So we'll keep continuing further so that this is the introduction what I have given to you. Tarun? Tarun?
Yes, sir.
Got it. Understood all the process. Okay. Okay. So regarding the test, so all of you saw your marks. What is the reaction? Good, huh? All of you happy about it? Tarun?
Yes, sir. Can we see our responses? Like, can you send a sheet? Consisting of all the responses that we have.
Each question. Now that's a big Excel sheet, man. Maybe, yeah, okay, we can send up, but why? You got any doubt?
No, sir, just to confirm, like, what question we went wrong now.
Okay.
Actually, in MMM, we got the same Excel sheet, like, consisting of all the responses that
we can do. No, I just didn't want to do that. Just share the thing. We can send the main Excel sheet also. That's not a problem. I just sent you the scores because I thought in detail you would have known. No, you would answer the question. Oh, we can send that. No problem. I'll send it.
Okay, sir. There won't be an issue, sir. No.
Huh?
There won't be any issue, sir. Like,
yeah, no issues. Only Siddharth and who's at 401 Mahesh, no? So they both have got some problems. I don't know what, they didn't press the submit button or something. So the result has not come. Okay, anyway, so all of you have done well. I think it should not be a problem. So module one and module two, we are completed in the test itself, isn't it?
Yes,
so yeah. Now what I am doing now is a part of the fourth module. Dimension analysis is one portion. Boundary layer theory is another portion. Okay. So if we complete this, we'll be completing the fourth module. Okay. So it should not be any problem. I've given you the material also, and sufficient problems we have done already on both things. Okay. So next class I want to continue the boundary layer theory. We'll do some more problems. Then we'll get acquainted with that, and you will also gain confidence. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's what I have. And, yes. And anybody, if you got the textbook, R.K. Bansal or any textbook, it's okay. Otherwise, no problem. I can share you the notes what I have got with you. I can send it to you by the group or Google Classroom also. Okay.
Thanks.
Okay, any other doubts? Why many few people have come today, still not come out of the test mode? Today morning it was there, no? After that, you have not come to the class. Why very few students are there?
Test mode.
Okay. Anything else you want to discuss or hello?
No, sir. Nothing.
Okay.
No, sir. That's it.
Okay. So these are the problems. Please go through the problems. I've given the study material. Go through that, and we'll see what can be done. Best. We'll continue with some more problems. And today evening I will share the study material to you. Okay. Module 4 I will share it to you. Okay. So that should not be a problem. You keep practicing some more problems. Okay. Then we can finish that. Okay. If yeah, any doubts, any queries, anything is there? Yes? Okay. If nothing is there, okay, then we'll wind up today's class. Okay. We'll conclude. Hello?
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, yeah. Sir.